Now, next one will be, see, we know that the resistance of a conductor R is equal to, we have got ML by Ae square A tau from our previous derivations. So now in this particular equation, if M the mass of the electron, L the length of the conductor, N is the number of free electron per unit volume, E is the charge of each electron, and A is the area of cross section. So if all these things are taken to be constant, then what we can say? Then we can say that R is inversely proportional to tau. Tau is the relaxation time. That is the average time in between two collisions. So now, the RMS velocity of the free electron, VRMS, the root mean square speed of the free electron, is, can be written as equal to lambda by tau. What is lambda? Lambda is the mean free path. That means the average path in between two successive collisions. And tau is the relaxation time. So VRMS will be lambda by tau. Therefore, we can write tau is equal to lambda by VRMS. So therefore, we can, if you, this equation is 1. So if you put this equation, value of this tau in this equation, so we can say R is proportional to VRMS by lambda. So therefore, now this VRMS, the root mean square velocity of the free electron, is depending on the root over temperature. That means if the temperature increases, VRMS increases. And as VRMS increases, then R is also increases. So therefore, if the temperature increases, we can say that resistance of the conductor increases. And similarly, if the temperature increases, lambda decreases, the average distance between the collision decreases. So there also this resistance will increase. So that is why we can say that resistance is directly depending on the temperature. So if the temperature increases, then resistance also increases.